Under the Vedanta school of Indian philosophy, we have Advaita Vedanta, Vishishta Advaita, Dvaita, Dvaita Advaita, and Shuddha Advaita. Now, a very important question arises. When Vedanta basically means the end of the Vedas and a simple philosophy is followed, that means the end of the Vedic sacrifices and the emphasis that was put on the importance of mantras and yajnas, etc., then why do we have these so many different schools under the Vedanta? This video will help you understand the importance of the different schools and why exactly we have them. In this video, we are going to study the Vishishta Advaita school of Vedanta philosophy, which is founded by Ramanuja. We will also deal with the concept of Saguna Brahman, the concept of Arthapak Siddhi, and the concept of Parinamavada as advanced by Ramanuja himself. Ramanuja was an influential philosopher of the Vedanta school of philosophy. He is regarded as one of the most influential exponents of Vaishnavism tradition. The Vaishnavism tradition has four major sects. Ramanuja's sect is called Sri Sampradaya, Madhava's is called Brahma Sampradaya, Nimbarka's is called Sanak Sampradaya, and Vallabha's is called Rudra Sampradaya. Now, this answers the first question that was put up in the starting of the video as to why do we have these so many different schools of Vedanta. Now, as we have just read, Ramanuja was an influential philosopher of Vedanta school, and as a result, he has written a number of major texts. Some of the important ones are Sri Bhashya, Vedartha Sangraham, Vedanta Sara, Gita Bhashya, etc. The philosophy of Ramanuja is called Vishishta Advaita, which also means qualified monism. He believes that the absolute reality or Brahman possesses two qualities. Now, these two qualities are matter and soul, or chit and achit. Chit means soul and achit means matter. Matter and soul are, according to Ramanuja, although real and eternal in nature, but they are absolutely dependent on Brahman. In simpler words, this means the absolute contains the many. This monism of Ramanuja is called qualified monism or Vishishta Advaita. So basically, you can also say that Brahman is that somebody who possesses both the conscious and the unconscious substance, and that unconscious and conscious substance is nothing but chit and achit, so there is identity in difference. Ramanuja accepts three pramanas or the sources of knowledge. They are perception, inference, and verbal testimony. According to Ramanuja, God or Brahman is full of positive attributes. He is the absolute being who has infinite attributes such as knowledge, bliss, omnipotence, existence, benevolence, etc. So from this we get to know that he believed in the concept of Saguna Brahman. Saguna means somebody who possesses all the positive attributes. Now, it is important to note that, like Ramanuja, Madhavacharya also rejects the concept of Nirguna Brahman, and they both accept the concept of Saguna Brahman. Nirguna means absence of qualities, and Saguna means presence of all qualities. The Saguna nature by Ramanuja is defined as, he says, Brahman cannot be indeterminate, qualityless, or undifferentiated substance. This basically means Brahman is determinate and qualified in nature. That is called Savishesha, because he is qualified by chit and achit, or matter and soul, which are his two attributes. Now, what is this Brahman or God that we are referring to? Ramanuja believed him to be Lord Vasudeva, who lives in Vaikuntha and is made up of pure sattva. As a result, he is the divine being, a personal God who is both immanent and transcendental in nature. He is regarded so because his presence and his essence takes the form of holy idols and images. He is also the Lord of Dharma. He punishes the wicked souls and shows His grace upon those who worship Him and do good. Further, Ramanuja says that Lord Vasudeva manifests Himself in five forms to His devotees. These five forms are: He is Antaryami. Antaryami is somebody who is called the inner controller. He is Para. Para means supreme. He reveals Himself through the four yuhas. He comes down on earth in the form of animal or human form. That is called incarnation. As a result, He is called Avatara or Vibhava. Lastly, He takes the form of holy idols, images that we see in temples and homes, etc. And it is called Archanavatara. So what Ramanuja is trying to say is, Brahman or Lord Vasudeva is regarded as the creator, the preserver and the destroyer. His manifestation as the ruler of emotional aspect of soul is called Manastattva. His manifestation as the ruler of cognitive aspect of soul is called Jivatattva or Buddhitattva. This is easy to infer because we use the word cognitive here. Lastly, His manifestation as the ruler of the volitional aspect of soul is called Ahankara Tattva. So from this, we can easily infer that Ramanuja recognizes three realities which are called Tattva Traya. These are Brahman, Chit and Achit, or Brahman, soul and matter. The Chit is soul, the Achit is matter, are both equally real and eternal, but they are absolutely dependent on Brahman because they are His attributes or Prakara. Because God is the soul of nature and He is the soul of other souls too. Now, this relation between matter, soul and God, or Achit, Chit and Brahman, is that of inner inseparability. This inner inseparability is nothing but called Arthapak Siddhi. So we are saying Arthapak Siddhi is also known as the relation of inner inseparability, which is organic in nature. It is organic in nature because, let's say we have an example in front of us, which is a jug which is made up of clay. Now, the jug and the clay can also be known as a whole and a part. Now, it is important to note that the whole and the part cannot be separated from each other, because there is a concept of inner inseparability between the two. The jug is made up of clay and the clay is what constitutes the jug. Likewise, such is the relation between Brahman, Chit and Achit, or soul, matter and God. Ramanuja says that matter and soul are controlled, supported, parts and means of God or Brahman. On the other hand, God is the controller, the support provider, the whole and the end. So although matter and soul are both eternal and real in nature, like we said before, they are both completely dependent on God. Therefore, God is free from both the differences, heterogeneous and homogeneous differences. They are also called Vijatiya Bheda and Sajatiya Bheda, because there is nothing which is external to God or Brahman or Vasudeva. According to Ramanuja, God possesses internal differences, which is called Swagata Bheda. Now, why does God possess these internal differences is because God is made up of different elements, like we have discussed, Chit and Achit, that is matter and soul. Hence, God is qualified by matter and soul both. Lastly, we deal with the concept of Parinamavada. Parinamavada deals with the theory of creation. Ramanuja accepts the theory of Brahma Parinamavada. Parinamavada is a form of Satkaryavada. Now, Satkaryavada, as you would know, means effect necessarily pre-exists in the cause, according to which the material cause changes itself in the form of its effect. So, the effect is the real transformation of its material cause. According to Ramanuja, the universe, which includes both Chit and Achit, that is matter and soul, is a real modification of Brahman, and that is why it is called Brahma Parinamavada. According to Ramanuja, Prakriti or the cause is dependent on Brahman, it is controlled by him and it is also inseparable from him. And this is why God makes both the material cause, that is matter is an attribute of God, and he also makes the efficient cause of the universe. So we can say that according to Ramanuja, God, that is Brahman or Vasudeva, is both the material cause and the efficient cause of the universe or the creation. Question 1. Choose the incorrect statement. Ramanuja belonged to Shaivism tradition. Ramanuja's sect is called Sri Sampradaya. He advocated the theory of Arthapak Siddhi. He believed in the concept of Saguna Brahman. The correct answer is B. Out of all the above statements, the only incorrect statement is the statement number 1. Ramanuja belonged to Vaishnavism tradition and not Shaivism tradition. Question 2. Dash is called Avatara, Para, Pure Sattva, Vibhava, etc. The correct answer is Lord Vasudeva. According to Ramanuja, God or Brahman is Vasudeva and it is made up of pure Sattva. Some of his characteristics are, he is Antaryami, he is Para or Supreme, he reveals himself through the four Yuhas, he comes down on earth in the form of human or animal form, that is incarnation, he is Avatara, Vibhava, etc. Question 3. Tattva Triyaya means, the correct answer is Brahman, Chit and Achit, that is Brahman, soul and matter. Ramanuja recognizes three realities which are called Tattva Triyaya. The Chit and Achit are both real and eternal, but according to Ramanuja, they are absolutely dependent on Brahman because Chit and Achit are his two attributes or Prakara.